What's up, guys? Welcome to our brand new streaming studio. If you have seen the video that I made, I want to say about 7 months ago, called How I Built My Dream YouTube Studio, this is a similar setup. In fact, I did move from that previous studio. I just took everything and the same paint color, brought it to a new apartment, and did everything the same. But there are small differences and new features that I built in to make this the ultimate streaming setup. We're gonna go over it right now and show you the whole thing so you can get lots of ideas for your own streaming setup. And we'll go over some do's, but also don'ts of things that we learned while building that you definitely shouldn't do. We made those mistakes, so let's make sure you don't have to make them either. And stay tuned for the end. We'll show you our whole streaming interface right here and how we operate it with all these cool graphics so that we can show you the gameplay, show you the full cam, and all the cool features we have for the stream, like live chat and stuff like that on display. What's up, guys? Chandler here with my Great Dane puppy Hobbs. He's about 7 months old, 120 pounds. I'm over here with the Bob Barker or Drew Carey mic, depending on how old you guys are, if you watch The Price is Right, just for the best sound quality possible. This right here is the main set for the YouTube studio portion of this room. Whenever we film YouTube videos, this is the main area. Now, right here, we have the newest addition to the set, which is the Rise neon light. It's got a dimmer on it. It is absolutely amazing. I actually got it in the mail 3 hours before we went on our first ever live stream, which was incredible timing. Came all the way from China. I got it on Etsy, which is an amazing website. If you haven't been there before, it's not a paid endorsement. It really just is a really cool website where you can get really cool custom artwork. So I got this custom neon sign right here. Now I'll show you guys some behind the scenes stuff. Obviously it is wired in over here and it is voice controlled and controlled by my phone to turn on and off and dim, but we could not have that wire hanging down. So I had to go Mr. DIY over here and make sure that we could get this cord fed through the wall. We had to dig a couple holes, repaint it, and I love the final product. It turned out so amazing. Now, if you're familiar with the channel, you've seen this before. We have the deck display. It is actually an old cassette display, which I got for $5 off of Facebook Marketplace. So I can't link that in the description, but everything else will be linked in the description because this is just an old cassette tape display. Obviously, we have the 100,000 subscribers plaque, which is all you guys. Thank you so much for supporting us as per usual. And these are intricate 3D displays of Rise playing cards, which are really, really cool. We have a whole video on that linked in the description. Let's see what else. We have that chair, which just an average normal chair. However, it does have some slobber marks on it because it is definitely Hobbs' favorite hangout spot. When I'm at the computer editing and doing stuff like that, working, he loves to just sit there and hang out, even though he's very quickly getting way too big for it. Right here, Christmas tree. It's not a permanent thing, but it's definitely at a very, very good spot. Wall color. The paint is called Calligraphy. It's by Bear Paint. I know I got a lot of comments about that on the last studio tour video. It's the same color, same everything. So if you want to know what it is, that's what it is. Moving along, that is our first ever piece of fan art made by our friend AJ Jackson. He's in that to us, I want to say, about 2.5 years ago. Absolutely amazing. Moving on, if you guys have watched the old studio tour, I go into a lot more detail in that video on lots of this stuff. But I'll skim through it this time so we can get right back to the Twitch setup and streaming setup. This is a workbench by IKEA. I just really like the aesthetic and the way it works. The pegboard is also by IKEA. And then we have an assortment of camera lenses, camera equipment, drones, media passes for my job, tools, all color coordinated, along with another YouTube 100,000 subscribers plaque. Shout out you guys. Like I said, if you want more info on all this stuff, be sure to watch the studio tour, because we go into all of that in detail. And if you're a photographer or videographer or just interested in it, I also did make a video on all of my camera gear, especially the one that we're filming with right now. So if you're interested in any of that, I will also link that in the description. So that's this corner. And this, what we just went over, makes up what you see in the backdrop of our streaming setup. So I think that's the most important thing, is lighting. Now going into lighting, we have that accent light right there. We have the Rise neon light, and we also have Alexa lights, smart lights on the top of the ceiling. What's great about that, like right now, if we want natural white light, we just have it on white. But for our streaming setup, one of the really cool color schemes that we like to do is teal and orange. We obviously have the orange accent light here, orange accent light here. And then all I have to do is say, Alexa, turn the studio lights blue. And now we're all ready to go for our stream. Obviously I have another light here for our video, so it wouldn't be this light over on this end. We like to keep it dark so you can see all the accents, but this is sort of the vibe we're looking for over here. Now, like we said at the beginning, we're not just telling you the do's of building a streaming studio. We're also gonna tell you the don'ts. And one of the don'ts that I'd regretfully say because it took me so much time. As you guys see, I made the joke about the Bob Barker microphone right here, right now. There's a reason why I'm doing this, is so we have better sound quality. I thought that soundproofing the entire ceiling would help the echo in this room, but it really hasn't whatsoever. So really the best way, if you're trying to build a streaming setup or a YouTube studio to get good quality sound, it's much more about the microphone you're using, the proximity to your mouth, rather than soundproofing the whole thing, because the entire ceiling is soundproofed with these foam pads and acoustic pads. And since I'm in an apartment and a rental place, what I did was I took that cork board, that foam board that you made your like dioramas on in elementary school, and I mounted it to the ceiling with command strips and then put the adhesive on the foam pads to that. So when I have to move out, we take it all down like nothing ever happened. But that's a don't, okay? It was not worth it. It took me a long time. Over here, we have the From Nothing poster. That's from my first feature film that I made with my friend Joe Pfeiffer. Linked in the description, you can find more about that and the job I do for a living. What else? Over here, really cool feature. We'll have to sneak over the desk for a second. If you look on the ceiling, talking about lighting the backdrop of our studio, it's gonna be tough to see with this big light on, but I'll definitely make sure to show it to you when we're at the Twitch setup. Right here, we have another accent light, spotlight on the ceiling that's controlled RGB as well. And that's gonna shine down on the deck display and it can go any color we want it to. But in this case, we're gonna have to go orange because it matches the whole setup, but it can also strobe and do different colors and hit the deck display and the plaque in really cool ways. So that was only $10 on Amazon and it was for a pack of two. I have an extra one sitting in the closet. They each have a remote. It's a really cool product. Super cheap, plasticky, but it works exactly as advertised, which you gotta love. Let's put that back to orange. And that's sitting at the desk while we're streaming. Now over here, we have this, which is just a cool aesthetic thing that I built when I had my old studio at my old place. And obviously, you guys didn't even know I moved because I took the whole studio and just transported it here. You guys had no idea and rebuilt the whole thing all over again with the additions that we're going over now. But this, I'll show some B-roll of the time-lapse of me building it. I just wanna make a cool photo backdrop where we could take studio level shots like you see here. We have gray, white, and black. Plus, I just think it looks cool. Now, lots of you guys love this desk from the last video we did. Yes, it is pretty basic now. A lot of people do it, but sometimes there's a reason why things are popular, just because they're the best. So we got the Carlby desk set up right here. I believe it's 89 inches, but it's the longest version. I'll have that link in the description with two Alex drawer chests holding it up. And unfortunately, we got some books holding it up to make it a little higher, make it a little even. It was the easiest way for me to do things. Hey Hobbs, he just came from his favorite spot over there. Now at the desk here, we just got, you know, a Himalayan salt lamp that Grant got me for my birthday a little bit ago. We just got a little fake plant here to, you know, add a little vibe, a little bit of color over to the desk here. This is a little drawer setup, the heavy sniper rifle from Fortnite. Grant got that for me for my birthday. The impossible bottle here with Rise playing cards. How did the deck get in a sealed glass bottle? Who freaking knows?
I don't.
Now over here, Grant's gonna explain all the streaming equipment we have, but since this is my desk where I do my full-time job, which is sports documentary filmmaking editing, I will point out that one of the things I would say that's a don't of streaming is that both of these monitors are actually ultra wides. They're 21:9 monitors. I prefer that as a professional video editor. That's what I prefer to edit on, and that is my main profession. So that is why this setup is the way it is in terms of the dual monitor setup. When you're watching a stream of any sort, it's gonna be displayed 16:9 and almost everyone's gonna be watching on a 16:9 display. So you'll see in some of our Twitch graphics, we made borders for the 21:9 setup here, but I would recommend that you use a 16:9 monitor because that is the gold standard. And that's also when you can get a monitor in a high refresh rate. That's what I recommend. I'm not switching over to it right now because I'm not a full-time streamer. I'm a full-time video professional, so I gotta do what's best for my job. Up here, speaking of my job, you guys saw all the cameras we got. We're filming on a Canon C200. Once again, we have a video on all our cameras, but this was a Sony A6400 that, I hate to say it, was just kind of sitting around collecting dust because of my newer cameras. But at the same time, a resale value of a five-year-old camera isn't that high. So I was like, I don't really want to sell it. Then I watched a couple of videos on how to make it the streaming camera. It's pretty simple, and I'll leave the link to the video I learned from and the equipment that I used to make it into a webcam in the description below. It's basically just an Elgato capture card with a battery that has a plug in it so the camera can constantly stay on. Now, my favorite feature before I hand it off to Grant is this light right here. I'll show you the difference that it makes when we're sitting at the computer, but it really makes a huge difference in terms of how the stream looks to have a good light on your face so that our accent lights in the back look pristine. Okay, and that will be linked in the description. It's just a little ring light, plugs into USB, constant power. Have the remote right here, and we can make it darker or brighter and change the temperature. So see, now it's warm, now it's cold, but I like to keep it right at neutral. All right, Grant, take it away. Now it's your time to be Drew Carey.
So going into the actual tech equipment that we have on the desk, we have a few things that are just, that just make sense. The first one, the way you interact with everything, will be just the keyboard. Now this is an AnPro 2. It's just a very minimal 60% keyboard. Still getting kind of used to it because it's missing a lot of the function keys and the number keys, but it's small, it's clean, and it works for everything we have. What we have next, other than the keyboard, is a Logitech G602. This is a mouse. Sharon uses it. I have a different one. I personally have a Logitech MX Master 2 that I love, but Sharon likes this one for all the little buttons on the side that he can macro or mirror shortcuts to, and his building keys in Fortnite.
Both types of editing.
Both types of editing.
Editing in Fortnite and editing in Premiere.
Got to keep your edits crisp no matter what you're doing. Now, both the keyboard and the mouse are on this nice large mouse pad that we got from Amazon. Very clean, black. No logos. Now what we have next is one of the most important things that you can have in a setup, and that is audio. Those of you who play video games know how important audio is. Those of you who edit video know how important audio is. So what we got here is just a pair of Logitech speakers. They're very cheap. They get the job done. If you need to hear something, you can hear it. But nothing too special. They're just here in case both me and Sharon need to hear something at the same time. But the reason we don't have too much in the actual speakers is so that we can have a nice headset here. Now this headset by Audio-Technica will be linked down in the description below. It's a phenomenal headset, open back so you can hear the world around you, which is very important for us. So if we're wearing this headset, we can hear Hobbs getting into the trash and know to go take care of it. Fits on the head nicely. I can still hear my voice. I can still have everything else. Phenomenal. In terms of making audio, we have this phenomenal broadcaster mic. It is on this nifty little pole, is weighted and adjustable, so we can bring this microphone exactly wherever we want. Now this microphone is the Razer Siren X. If any of you guys watch the live stream, you know that what I said earlier about this being a phenomenal microphone is not true.
This is bad.
So shout out Alpha Gaming for letting us know that this mic is, without a doubt, the worst microphone in its price point. So we're not gonna link this one in the description. Like he said, any other microphone in this price range will be better. We're personally gonna be switching to the Blue Yeti, so this thing is not gonna be here for too much longer. But as of right now, it has this pretty light whenever we mute it, so guess that's a plus. On to the actual computer. Now this computer is about a year old now, and that is because around that time, Chandler, his laptop that is right here, it just wasn't cutting it for him anymore. So he told me, yo, for video editing, I just need an absolute beast. Something that can handle anything that I throw at it. It can handle multiple monitors. It can do After Effects, Premiere Pro, 4K, 8K for future proofing, whatever. Help me out. What we did, we went out, found a bunch of computer parts, strapped them all together, and built this rig right here. Now you might ask, what's in there? A lot more details in the description, but for right now, we have an Intel Core i9 processor. For the graphics card, we got a 2070 Super, got 64 gigs of RAM. Pretty much all that matters is the graphics card, the CPU, and the RAM. But any other information about the power supply, the motherboard, the cooling system, will all be down in the description for those of you who are nerds like me and really care. This computer is just really powerful. We weren't even planning on streaming when this thing was built, But in our testing, this thing was able to handle it no issues. Now, I have seen a lot of people out there who like to stream with two PCs, one handling the gameplay and the other handling the actual streaming. We looked into streaming with two PCs, but honestly, in our testing, this thing was able to handle any video game that we threw at it at max settings, as well as streaming it at 60 frames per second and 1080p. So there really was no need for it. This thing can handle it no issues at all.
Now, before we get into the actual setup from the camera, I want to go over one last important thing when we're talking about do's and don'ts of streaming that is definitely not necessary, but man, for our stream, it has made an incredible difference. I absolutely love this thing. It's called the Stream Deck from Elgato. And what it does is it syncs with streaming programs like OBS or Streamlabs OBS. And what it does is it syncs with your whole graphical setup right here with these interchangeable buttons. So I can make these buttons anything I want them to be. This one takes us right to risemagic.com, as you can see with the little Rise logo there. If we're playing Call of Duty and someone starts saying some naughty words, I hit this little emoji with the bleep out. And when you let them know, that doesn't fly on our stream, we'll bleep that out. All right. We have artlist.io where we play our streaming music, obviously an OBS shortcut, but we also have all seven of our scenes on here. So right here, you'll see it goes to our starting soon screen that we'll put at the start of every stream. And then we're gonna go over all these from the actual output of the stream, but this middle button's the transition sound. So let's say we're on starting soon, we wanna go to our full cam. What we do is we hit full cam and the transition sound at the exact same time. It plays the transition sound and switches us right to full cam, just like that. We also have ones for cam plus chat. Since we're not currently live on YouTube, there is no chat, but man, our first live stream, the chat was popping off. We obviously have gameplay, which will show the full cam right here and what's being displayed in our gameplay monitor, which right now is rise-magic.com/store, where you can go to purchase our products. We also have, I don't want to expose it now, but we have found a way to play and stream some retro games through a lot of Frankenstein connections and capture cards on the GameCube and Nintendo Wii. So we do have the GameCube symbol in the Stream Deck. If in the future we're going to play some classic games on stream, which basically just puts us into the 4:3 aspect ratio of GameCube. So the Stream Deck has been extremely helpful for us. When we were streaming and we had that many people watching us, it's so easy to just have this piece of technology that's really like a TV studio setup where you have live switches and you're directing your own stream. It's incredible. So let's hop into the stream. We can show you the graphics and everything from there.
All right, guys, so this is how our stream looks like in full cam setup right here. We just did our first stream a couple of days ago. We had over 5,000 viewers, at some points almost 1,000 concurrent, so it was wild. It was really awesome to see, and man, I was really happy that we got to debut our streaming graphics like this. We kept them a secret for a long time. So like I just showed you with the Stream Deck right here, we have full cam, and like I said, cam plus chat. Obviously, chat is disabled for this live stream because we're not currently live, but here's some B-roll of what it looked like when we were live and the chat was popping off. Super awesome. Here's gameplay. So when we're gaming like this, let's see, besides gameplay, we have, like I said, GameCube for some of the retro games we'll be playing on the stream in the future. And that's pretty much it, guys. So the transition that plays every time, absolutely. Fan of that, and the transition noise was something that I actually crafted by myself to match the transition, which was really fun to do. So really, that's our whole setup. As you can tell, there is a lot of work that has been put into the aesthetic of it when we're both sitting here duo streaming, or when I'm solo streaming playing games with Grant when he's on their PC. I really love the way the accent light from the Alexa light works, along with that neon, super clean. I'll turn on the spotlight that I was talking about so you can see how it looks right there, so it adds a little bit of a flare, and the Rise logo is dimmable, so we can turn that down. I'll just put on strobe for the rest of the video. Strobe, different colors over there. You can barely see it because of the accent light.
So I hope you guys enjoy the tour. This is a lot of effort, a lot of fun though, and we're super excited to be putting this to action every Monday and Thursday. For those of you who are watching this video right when it comes out, today is Thursday, which means that at 8 p.m. tonight, Eastern Standard Time, we'll be live again. Tonight, we're gonna be playing some games. We have a few
Rise
ideas.
Game night. We could be playing Fortnite, we could play in Warzone, we could play in Clue, Super Monkey Ball, Super Smash Brothers, Among Us. So many options for us to have fun and play with you guys. So
be sure to tune in. And if you're into card stream and Magic, we will be giving away decks. We give away a lot in our first stream. So we are streaming live every Monday at 7 p.m. and every Thursday at 8 p.m. Be sure to watch our trailer, linked in the description, if you don't know about all the awesomeness that will be happening on this channel.
At this time, the stream reminder should be live, and you can click a button to notify you as soon as it actually starts. Until then, leave a comment down below letting us know what you want to see us play tonight. We're excited to join you, and we hope you'll have as much fun as we will.
Peace out, guys.
Peace out.